could be because we are sitting on a little bit of an angle. A few look like they did actually cross through the drainage line. I can see the rest of the family coming out. Oh. Let's see what that was about. I'm hoping what they're going to do is go a bit further around so we can go onto their wall and actually view them, which would be really fantastic to see. I'm just going to give them a little bit more space, especially with the babies just being so young. You don't want to crowd them too much. Not that you want to crowd an elephant anyway, but... certainly with so many young. Perfect, they are going to that spot. Wonderful. Moving the buffalo on. Another baby just to the right of them who's quite far into the water at the moment. Buffalo making its way. Mark, do you recognise the female that has the tusk hanging down? Mark's recognising that female. Oh, we have seen her before. Quite interesting, that youngster's actually looking like it's using its mouth to drink rather than its trunk. struggling to get up the bank. I just noticed. And the one that's actually sliding down the bank. Oh, it's just got back of now. It was actually sliding right down the bank into the water. If baby's going to come back down to the water again. helping hand there. You see how she was just nudging her foot just to help it out the water. Always somebody to keep an eye on the youngsters. There's a further round in the vegetation there, also rolling around a little bit. I thought maybe we might get one or two swimming, but obviously they decided that they just want to drink instead. Now, many books will quote many different values of how much water an elephant can hold in its trunk. It can be anywhere between 4 and 10 litres, depending on the size of the elephant. If you watch carefully, they won't actually suck the water right up into the trunk. They do have to squirt it into the mouths. And if it's particularly muddy water and there's not much other water to drink around, you will see them trying to filter off the top layer so they don't get too much sediment in there. some of the adults have decided rather than have a water bath, they're going to have a dust bath instead. Also helps to dislodge any parasites, flies. One of the juveniles has succumbed. Once he saw how much enjoyment the younger ones got from it. They do have a buoyancy, so rather than sinking, they will rather float. And where there's Asian elephants on small islands, they will swim between those islands. Well, I hope definitely not a disappointment. We're going to continue on down Central Road so we may get another glimpse of them as we leave them.